Hey everyone, welcome to Judging for the Win. I'm Dave, and this is my daily ruling. Today's the start of Crimson Vow Week, so I wanted to take a question that I thought would be really interesting and something that would be really important to know if you're doing any limited events in Crimson Vow. Can you name blood with Pithing Needle in order to stop people from sacrificing blood tokens? Alright, so the first thing that I want to do with this question is take a close look at exactly what Pithing Needle says. We can see that Pithing Needle asks us to choose a card name. Now, tokens are not cards, which means that if we are going to choose a card name, we have to choose the name of a card that appears in the Oracle card database. Notice, however, something interesting. Neither the Pithing Needle nor that rule that I pulled up on screen puts any stipulations on what card name that we can pick, which means that if there happens to be a card somewhere in Magic's history that happens to be named Blood, that is fair game to name with Pithing Needle. Whether or not that card has any activated abilities, or whether or not that card is legal in the format that we're playing, those are completely irrelevant. If there's some card somewhere that's named Blood in Magic's history, that means that we can name it. So, is there such a card? That's pretty interesting, don't you think? Especially when you consider this rule here, which says that if you're considering a split card and you're asked to choose a card name, you can choose the card name that either half of the split card has, but not the combined name that the split card has together. So, taking this case for as an example, we could choose the name Flesh or Blood, but we could not choose the name Flesh and Blood together with Pithing Needle. So, that means that it is definitely possible for us to have Pithing Needle naming Blood on the battlefield. If you had asked me this question any time before Crimson Vow came out, that would have been the end of the story. However, there's one more piece of information we're going to need to get a complete answer here. And that is, what is a token's name? All tokens have names. Sometimes the token effect that makes the token says what the name of the token is going to be. Other times, the token effect is going to say that the token is a copy of something, and the name is going to be one of the things that gets copied in those types of cases. However, even if neither of those is the case, the token still will have a name. What would that be? Well, the token's name is just going to be the subtypes that the token has, plus the word token afterwards. Now you might be able to see a little bit of a problem. It turns out that blood and blood token are not the same thing. So, if you have a Pithing Needle out that's naming Blood, and you want to activate the ability of a permanent you control whose name is Blood Token, well, that's not going to be the same, so the Pithing Needle is going to do absolutely nothing to stop people from sacrificing their Blood Tokens. This is a change that was made in the rules with Crimson Vow, and this is exactly the sort of shenanigans that it was intended to stop. So, now we have the full answer for the question that we had at the beginning of the video. Yes, you can name blood with Pithing Needle, but no, it is not going to do anything at all to stop people from sacrificing blood tokens. And that's all I have for you today. How did you do? Join me again tomorrow for another daily ruling, but until then, I hope you have a great day.